The experience of my family and my parents was that of a Greek immigrant family. Neither my dad nor my mother were well educated, and so my dad joined his brothers in the traditional Greek business startup, a very small luncheonette, and my dad manufactured homemade ice cream and homemade candies. Well, experience at P&S were initially traumatic, because I have a very bad memory. And I learned that during my early childhood development, where I could not memorize anything. Same thing reiterated when I went to medical school, because the first major course in 1950 was human anatomy, which is all memory, 100%. And I struggled, and I did get through the course, but it was uphill from then on. Everything got better because it was soon biochemistry and pharmacology and things that I could actually figure out. I was able to do things, which is much more my personality. And so that was great fun. And of course, getting into research, I didn't have to memorize anything. It was a wonderful thing that I was supported with a scholarship, both at Penn and then later at medical school at Columbia. And so that was critical to my achieving what I did, because I was always able to follow my abilities and my dreams.
Roy is truly a remarkable person. Trained as a clinician, became chair of a department of biochemistry, moved to Merck, where he made it the world's most admired company. An unbelievable career, spanning the full range of skills that one would ever be able to hope a graduate of a great medical school might achieve.
Enabling students to achieve what they're capable of achieving is a prime objective of mine, and I think of Diana's too.
It also helps you really, I think, stay connected to the future generation that makes you feel that things will go on and that you've had some influence on what's going to happen.
I'm turned on by accomplishments that have an impact rather than buying a boat. And if you go out here to Menemsha, you'll see people sitting on them where their monies, their life savings, go into a boat. I couldn't do that, mostly because I get seasick. It's very unlikely that a graduate of Columbia or any medical school who graduates with a debt of $200,000 is going to elect to go into primary care or pediatrics or research, because they have to start paying back that debt. That's crucial, and I think it limits the ability of our society to take advantage of the people who are coming through the system by having this burden.
I think Roy is a person who asks of others only what he has asked of himself. This is a very special person who has really given enormous amounts to Columbia, and I don't mean financially when I say that. I mean just in terms of his character, his person, and his dedication.
When we established the scholarship, we decided from the very beginning that we wanted to favor a student that was either an immigrant herself or a child of immigrants, because we felt that that was the smartest way to help any immigrant become part of our societal fabric.
I grew up in Puerto Rico, and I was actually raised by a single mother. Financially speaking, the only person in my family who's able to provide anything for me is my mother, and she's a social worker in Puerto Rico. And here at Columbia, Dr. Vagelos' scholarship has made a tremendous impact, because I've basically been able to go to medical school for free. It changed my life. It changed my life. And it might sound cliche to say that, but it did. And, you know, me, my mom, my family, we're all very grateful that I was given this scholarship, because I can't explain in words how much more amazing my medical school experience has been without having that huge financial concern in the back of my mind.
Dr. Vagelos and his wife have been role models for me. They've not only helped me financially, but they've also been there for me. For example, I went to Dr. Vagelos several times to ask him for advice. I wanted to be, you know, a physician and a scientist as well, so he helped me. He gave me a lot of advice and support. So not just financially, but he has been a mentor for me and is very influential in my life. So I want to follow his example.
In a world that is as globally connected now, it means that these folks are still connected to their origin. And in that sense, they will, I think, reflect upon their experience and pass some of that on to their home country or to their families. And so those are ways in which you influence the world peacefully.
The people at Columbia University at the Medical Center are just as good or better than they ever were. The students are undoubtedly better than we ever were, but the facilities, which were new when I went there in 1950, are now 60 years older. And so there is an enormous need for newer equipment, newer buildings, and different kinds of space. And so the decision has been made that there should be a new campus-like facility at 168th Street for medical and graduate education.
From my perspective, I think from the institution's perspective, it's our privilege to be able to honor someone like Roy and to show how much we appreciate what he and Diana have done for us as an institution and to help me personally as well.